Enthusiasm, motivation, inspiration, joy. These are the things that make our lives richer, fuller, and more productive. They are also the qualities found in successful organizations and successful people.
We've all experienced this when you walk into the teacher's lounge and that person comes flying in, like, I got 5 years till retirement. And, you know, they don't like themselves. They don't like their job. They don't like the kids. And I'm thinking, you know, why wait 5 years? Do us all a favor.
When leaders, administrators, or executives have the task of developing these qualities, choosing the right speaker can make all the difference in the world.
There's a saying that says, anger and the inability to forgive is like poisoning yourself and hoping the other person dies. Have you ever noticed the most miserable people you know? They spend their lifetime poisoning themselves and hoping the other person dies. You know, it's as though that some of these people believe there must be some kind of reward at the end of life. Maybe there's an anal retentive trophy or something, you know? Hey, St. Peter, you know, I cut off the most people on the highway. Where's my trophy, you know? Woohoo!
Dr. Stephen Birchak, affectionately known as Dr. Bird, has the ability to bring these qualities to your organization. Mixing humor, stories, energy, passion, and a quarter of a century of experience in higher education, Dr. Bird can get an audience moving like no other speaker you've heard.
I think that also, when I say be the person that who sees the best in others, you know, we have to be that person who always sees those good things in people. Because, you know, I think that if you've ever had a difficult life and you've had people that see the worst in you, you know how difficult that can be. You know, I know for me, it's like I was very distractible as a kid. You may not believe this, but I was very distractible. And I'm distractible now. I'm like the king of distractibility. You know, I mean, my wife and I, we went out shopping a couple months ago, and remember very well, because she will trust me with the little basket, but not with the cart, you know, because that's the mothership. I might lose it or something. You know, like distractible kids, you send them on little missions. So she says, Steve, go get us some bananas. So I go and I get the bananas. And I take the bananas and I find our cart and I put them in the cart. And then I pat my wife on the back and I say, I'll meet you over at the deli. And I look up over at the deli and there's my wife in a red jacket. And I'm thinking, you know, either she's really fast or I just touched a stranger. And I look over here, there's a woman in a red jacket just like my wife. She's... The rest of the shopping trip, I'm hiding behind cereal boxes. So I always thought, you know, what it'd be like later on if she went to the security. And then the little man touched me. And then he said he wanted to meet me. So I guess my point is don't punish kids for distractibility, you know.
Successful author, professor, educator, athlete, and former National College Coach of the Year. Dr. Bird taps into a wealth of knowledge and experience. His presentations draw upon decades of education and a doctorate in counseling psychology from the University of Northern Colorado. Dr. Bird has the unique ability to apply principles relating to character, leadership, and change.
You have to think about what brought you through the things that were the toughest in your life. And I guarantee you, the quality of the person that was in your life is that they saw something in you that nobody else saw. Or at least they saw it better than everybody else. And I think that's one remarkable quality about teachers and coaches and mentors and parents who are building successful children is that they see something in them that other people don't.
You can count on humor. He's not afraid to let his guard down.
So what you do is you start off with this. For Presley in theory, and as you're walking down, you can see immediately the effect that it begins to have on you. Now, we top it off with this shades, of course, and the miraculous thing, one of the things I find is when I put this on, immediately I start to give positive regard because I think he's, thank you very much, and say thank you very much, and I find myself walking down the hallway saying, thank you very much. It's really good to be here. One thing that I use with civility, and this is, again, one of my guarantees for the day, is I like to use magic. And so when people ask me, to do something impossible in a meeting, I bring magic and I say, Steve, we'd like to have this done by Friday. Consider it done. If you don't want to get that flamboyant, that's okay. I'm going to give you a tool today that you can use that is unlike any other tool. This thing has kind of taken on a life of its own. I'm going to have to get a trademark on it. But say you don't want to be so forceful in trying to get civility out of people. You're really frustrated. You're in a meeting with people. And you're kind of, in one of those moods, but you don't want to say anything. Use what I use. This is an incredible tool. And we're going to make sure that we're going to supply one of these for everybody at lunchtime today. This is not a fork. This is called an incarceratory imaginator. So whenever you're frustrated with somebody in a meeting, they're getting on your nerves, but you don't want to say anything, you can imagine what they would look like if they were in jail. You can be a little subtle with it. You know, Bob, that's a really good idea. I carry these things. You know, you kind of have them ready on the draw so that when somebody gives you that line, you know, it's like, nobody ever thanks me for anything. I go, well, hey, let me start. And I just give them a little bit of an applause there and say, let me be the first to give you an applause. So, and that works for me.
And you can count on genuineness and inspiration.
Eric Fromm had a wonderful quote, and he said, give that which is alive in you. If nothing is alive in you, you have nothing to give. And that all of those things that are alive in us, we need to give those to the people that we work with.